Hey guys, how's it going? Austin Reed here, and today I'm going to show you guys how to set up auto updates for your N8N server. Now, in the last video, I showed you guys how to set up the server, so if you want to learn how to do that, check that out. And if you guys want to skip ahead and just go straight to the instructions, check the comments below. I've got instructions down below. You can copy-paste most of this. It's very simple, just a couple of steps. But let's go ahead and just get started. So, step one, we have a N8N server just installed. Step two, we're going to SSH into this server. Now, I showed you guys how to do that in the last video. So if you don't know how to do that, check out the last video. And we've got some instructions here that I typed up for you guys. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to make a script that will run on a timer to auto-update it. Okay. So we're going to copy this. And remember, we're in PuTTY. So we're just going to right-click and hit paste. And then we're going to hit enter. Bam. So this one you can just copy paste. You actually don't have to change anything. What this is going to do is this is going to stop your N8N. It's going to grab the latest N8N image. It's going to start N8N again. And then it's going to remove the old version that was previously installed. When you do this, it will not delete any data at all. So it'll be a seamless, fresh update and you won't lose anything. Your application might be down for like maybe 30 seconds, maybe a minute, maybe 2 minutes, kind of depends, but it's very little downtime at all. So now we have the script. Now we're going to make it an executable script. So we just right click, bam, and then we're actually just gonna test it, okay? And it'll tell us what it's doing as it's doing it. So it stopped N8N. All right, now it's pulling the latest image. All right, and then it installed it, it started it, it deleted the old version, and now it's up again. So now let me refresh the page and make sure it still works. So it does not look like it's working. Might take a second to reboot. There we go. There we go. Yeah, so it just takes a second. Like I said, it's only down for like a minute. But it's fully updated. There you go. So that's how we update, but we need to set that script to run on a timer, right? So then we go to the next step, which is scheduling auto run. So we're going to do a cron tab, which just means like something that runs on a timer. We're going to choose nano because that's the text editor we want. That's step two. So we're just going to click one, enter, bam. We're going to go all the way to the bottom of this file. Now, I'm going to explain how this works, but if you just want your application to update every Sunday at 3 o'clock in the morning, copy this line, paste it at the end. Literally just copy, right click, paste, control S, control X, you're done. Okay? If you want to know and schedule this for a different time, stay on the video and I'll explain. So, basically the way it goes like this. You've got your minute, hour, day of the month, day of the week, and then the script you want to run. So these are the different variables. So you can choose 0 to 59 minutes. So let's say, for example, I wanted to run it at, let's pick a random time, 2:30, right? So the first number would be 30 because the first one's minute. The next one would be the hour. Well, I want 2 o'clock in the afternoon. So that would be 14 because it's 24-hour clock. Day of the month, well, it doesn't matter what day of the month. It doesn't really matter what month either. But I want this to run on, like, Tuesdays, right? So Sunday's 0. So Monday's 1. Tuesday's 2. Okay, so we'll put 2. And then all we have to do is put the name of the script, which is right here. So we're going to add that. For example, if you want it to run at 2:30 p.m. on Tuesdays. Bam. So that's how that works, okay? Now, this is based off of server time, okay? So wherever your server's local time zone is based out of is when it will run. So you have to keep that in mind. If you're like in Australia and you set up a server in the U.S., it's probably going to be running up in the middle of the day. If you set it to run at midnight, right? But that's basically it. So we'll go to the bottom of this file. We already added the line to run midnight. You save. And you exit. That's it. You're done. Now your server will auto-update, mine will at least, every Sunday at 3 o'clock in the morning. Hope this helped you out. You guys have a wonderful day.